Well, hi and welcome to Edison Light Globes. I'm Phil Greenwood and today what we're going to do is try to explain the mystery of what has changed with regard to light globes. We get a lot of questions about what is equivalent to what wattage, what brightness do I need in what location, how do I calculate the wattage for a spot in my house, how do I do all that? It's got very complicated. So to explain, we've got a range of different light globes here as they've changed over the years in technology. And probably the first globe we're going to look at is what we make, that is a replica of an old carbon filament type globe that has a hot wire, basically just a voltage through a wire that heats up. It creates a lot of heat. It's got a vacuum inside, so when they break, they explode into a million bits, and they're not very efficient. So this is a 25 watt globe, and it creates just an ambient type of light, not a great deal of light at all. And that was common for old-fashioned globes until they created the tungsten filament, which is a more modern, very small filament, but again, in a vacuum, just a hot wire with a voltage going through it. Now, these were a lot brighter. This is again, same wattage, 25 watts, but quite a bit brighter, a little bit ugly because of a very small filament, but still was the main globe for a number of years, and everybody remembers those. Then there was a shift to halogen globes, which are a little halogen light inside, this case, inside a regular shaped globe. Not a vacuum in there, but a tiny little vacuum inside the halogen component. These were a little bit more efficient. And that, I think, is 40 watts, a little bit brighter. But still a little bit ugly, not as attractive as the vintage globe, and certainly hard to use in a regular environment. You would need a dimmer if you needed to control it. You know, all sorts of things that were wrong with those, but they were efficient. And then about 20 years ago, we introduced the glorious compact fluorescent, which is probably the single ugliest globe ever invented. There's a lot wrong with it. It was efficient. It was mandatory use. And in fact, where we're from here, there's a little man came around from government money and he took all of our old globes and replaced them with these on the assumption that we would be using less energy. Now, these were reasonably efficient, but a lot more efficient than regular globes at the time, but certainly not as efficient as what came after. The other problem with fluorescent tubes is, again, they're a vacuum. When they break, they've got a lot of chemicals inside, like mercury and a few other things. You've got to be very careful when you dispose of them. They're not recyclable. A whole lot of things that were possibly wrong with these, but they're at least efficient. We do have a sheet here with a whole lot of relative lumens, and for brightness, what we're really looking at is not just lumens, but appropriate lumens. So for vintage globes and for decorative globes, what we need is a globe that isn't too bright that you can't look at it or you can't see it in your field of view. If it's too dazzling, too bright, it's not a really nice globe for decorative purpose, which is what we specialise in. If you need lighting for the cleaner to clean the floor or the benches, then sure, get as much light as you can into the place. But generally, for dining rooms, for wall lights, what you really need is a vintage globe or a... So the next globe I want to show you is what we used as the first type of LED globe. Essentially, it's a whole lot of little LEDs on a circuit board inside the glass envelope. Importantly, no vacuum required in here, so when they do smash, if that happens, they're not as explosive, which is a good thing. But also, one of the things about LED is they create very little heat because it's not a hot wire with a voltage going through. It's a light-emitting diode. So we turn this one on and we'll see this is a 3-watt globe. If you add all those up, it adds up to 3 watts. A decorative globe, a warm globe, a dimmable globe. Reasonably efficient by LED terms, but incredibly efficient compared to compact fluorescent. And look, we used those for probably 2 years and then things changed. And we ended up with what is an LED strip. Now these strips were mass produced in specific lengths. So we would put them all together into a little group like that. In this case, a little squirrel cage type affair to look a little bit like a vintage globe. And we were using these again for a decorative lighting purposes, but you can still use these in small rooms, or you can put 4 or 5 in a room. This one's particularly warm, but reasonably bright, again, only 5 watts. So for the amount of power that's being consumed, they're fairly bright, quite a high efficiency compared to older type technology globes. Now, in the last 2 years, what we've ended up with is a globe that we can fashion into any shape we like, at any length we like, because instead of short strips of LED, it's a single, long, continuous strip. So what that means is we get a nice decorative shape for the filament. But also with the efficiency of an LED. So this is only 3 watts and still reasonably capable in a decorative sense. So over a bench, over a dining table, 3 of these, enough light, perfect light. Again, all these globes have been designed, or all the ones we do, has been designed to be dimmable. Back in the 100 watt regular incandescent type globes, if you dimmed it to half, you probably used a little less than half the power, so you saved a little bit of power consumption by dimming them. With an LED, if you've got a 3 watt globe and you dim it by a phase cut type dimming, which is a different system, you might save 1 watt. So even though you do save a bit of power, it's now not a lot to save. So power consumption now is extremely small for the amount of output that you're getting in lumen, and so therefore people don't tend to worry about money savings. One of the things we'll do in the bottom of the video, we'll put down a little chart that we've made up that has some rough estimations of lumens per watt for different globe technologies. The hard part is brightness is lumens. That's the measure, that's the quantity that you need to be considering yourself with that. So unfortunately, a lot of people tend to know watts, meaning output and light, and I know what 25 watts and 60 and 100, I know what that means, but you have to abandon that and adopt lumens, or lumen, as the measure of brightness. So what we'll do, we'll put a little chart, and it'll give you a breakdown between the various globes, and if it helps manage when you're buying a globe, and it'll give you a rough idea of how bright it's going to be, and you can get used to lumens, that'd be great. So I hope that's been some help, at least. If you have any questions, you can always ask us on our website. You can always ask us in the comments below. But that's it for the current set of light globes that we've got. We do have other types of lighting systems that we use, but we might touch on that in another video. Anyway, if you like the videos, remember to subscribe. If you've got any questions, let us know. That's it for now. We'll see you again soon. Bye.